Good morning. It's 6:30 a.m. on Friday the 10th of September. Hank made a video recently called What the Heck Am I Doing? And I thought that I would match that by making a video called What the Heck Am I Doing? And talking about my recent professional projects. Because I think a lot of you don't really know what I do, and also most of my friends don't really know what I do. The big thing that's sort of been taking up a lot of my time, which might be quite big news to you, is that I'm starting a master's in 3 weeks. I'm doing a master's in migration, mobility and development. That came out of a 2-week short course I did this summer through SOAS called Conflict and International Development. And it was really rewarding. That's such a cliche thing to say, but it really was really rewarding. And one of the conveners of the course, who was a PhD student, encouraged me to look into the Migration, Mobility and Development Masters. So I did, and then I was like, ah, this is amazing. And I applied and I got in, and I start in a few weeks. And I'm really excited. And so I'm looking forward to getting my final timetable and all of that things. I'm looking forward to getting my student card, my student discount, just like all of that. So yes, good stuff on that front. That dovetails nicely with another aspect of my work. So I am a high level supporter, supporter for UNHCR, the UN Refugee Agency, who just issued their education report for 2021, featuring a final word by author John Green. So do read it. I'll link it in the description bar below. It's really interesting. That's also aside my work. I had a meeting recently with someone at UNHCR to talk about future projects, other things I want to make videos about, all sorts of stuff, and just to keep up to date with what's going on, because a lot of the time, obviously, Afghanistan's the most recent sort of news event, but even then, that's sliding out of the news now. But there's also Yemen, there's Mozambique, there's Ethiopia. There are all sorts of displacement events. There's the ongoing displacement of Rohingya refugees. It's a big world. But there are loads of things that we can do to help, and first and foremost is of course raising money, but then I also want to be very conscious about how I'm talking about refugee stories, especially because in the UK, and this is also part of the reason why I'm doing the Masters, it's a very hostile political climate for the refugee conversation, and it actually makes me really cross and I get really angry about it. The UK right now, it's a lot going on. That just takes up a lot of my mental energy. Speaking of things that I am supporting in part because of the situation in the UK right now. One second. I am a patron for the Women's Prize as of this year. It's my first year being a patron. And I was really, I suppose, inspired, encouraged, / decisive to do so, because the Women's Prize, in a climate of, frankly, hostility towards trans people, especially trans women here in the UK right now, I think it's important to firstly get involved with organisations that have a big voice, and the Women's Prize is really well respected. It has like my favourite shortlist, my favourite long list year in, year out. It has the Women's Prize for Fiction, which is like a £30,000 prize, but they also have this new Discoveries programme for emerging writers. And they host talks throughout the year, and I love their podcast, which is hosted by my friend Yomi. So I think they're really wicked and they're doing loads of things. But I also was encouraged by the fact that when the author of Detransition Baby, Tori Peters, started getting a lot of hate on the internet, and then also got this awful anonymous letter from a number of UK authors, I was impressed that the Women's Prize stood behind her. And it's sad that I was impressed, but such is the climate in the UK right now about trans rights. Like it's so I also think like the publishing industry as it is right now doesn't reflect the creative world that I'm involved in, and it doesn't reflect the kinds of books I read, because so much of the publishing industry, frankly, is very white and very wealthy. So if I can do anything within publishing world to help talk about things and get people on board who just reflect what publishing actually is and what it actually could be in 2021, I think that's really important. So that's kind of part of why I got involved. I'm still working with John, absolutely loving it. We just published our final episode of the Anthropocene Reviewed mini-series, which I produced. Obviously, the Anthropocene Reviewed book came out earlier this year, which if you haven't read, like, it's so, so beautiful. John's done like an incredible job with it, and I had a lot of fun doing a lot of research for the book and like giving feedback on it as it was being written, and also because we'd worked together on the podcast, it was fun seeing, you know, what essays work really well for audio but don't necessarily translate to the book, or how we change them, and all sorts of things like that. Like, it's really fun to be involved in a close way with the book process, because I don't know if you know, but I love books. So it was really fun doing the launch for that. John and I write a lot of silly tweets sometimes as well on the Anna Threary Reviewed Twitter, which is great fun, and I just love seeing your responses to that. So yeah, the book, the podcast came out. We just had the 300th episode of Dear Hank and John, John and Hank's advice podcast that I also produce. So I pick out the questions every week for that. I send John and Hank a list of 30 questions, and then also collate people's responses to previous episodes. And I love doing that. I love getting involved with it. And it just, I feel, it makes me feel very connected to the community of people like listening and also watching the videos and just like, interacting with the work. So that's still really exciting for me. And then Life's Library, our book club, in its third year, we are reading a book I love, Without You, There Is No Us, by Suki Kim right now. But I'm also reading ahead to a future book that's, I think, probably like 3 months away from being a Life's Library choice. So I'm rereading it so that I can write the letter that comes in with every Life's Library book. I'm also, so I can help out with the questions. Nikki, who I work with, writes most of the questions, but also sometimes I pitch in a little bit there. We record the podcast a few weeks in advance of the start of the reading period, so that by the time it goes through editing and everything, hopefully it arrives still with some weeks to come in the reading period. Sometimes it hasn't been able to. And yeah, coordinating with like Brandy and Abby behind the scenes, and Jessica and Nikki about future Life's Library things. There's just all sorts going on there. We're going to do a watch along of a film. I'm not sure which one yet, but we're going to do a watch along tomorrow night on Discord. So if you are around and interested, then please do join us for that, because it's always really fun. All profits from Life's Library go towards supporting our community's work to reduce maternal mortality in Sierra Leone, which once again dovetails beautifully with my master's, and was actually a huge encouragement in me for pursuing the development studies department line of further higher education. I love the work that Partners in Health does. I have learned so much from everyone involved, and I'm excited to continue to learn more from them as well. Okay, so Life's Library, and through Dear Hank and John. What else do I do? And then there's sort of ongoing project management type things that are just part of my work with John, whether that's like creative development of projects, or I don't know, just sort of like keeping tabs on different stuff is part of it. Sometimes weigh in on John's Vlog Brothers scripts, which he very kindly mentioned in a video recently. I don't know, there's always things. So it's that sort of like the more day-to-day type stuff. But yeah, it's sort of keeping tabs on all of these different avenues is also a big part of it. And then there's sort of like projects that are coming in and out. So for instance, the Project for Awesome charity telethon online video live stream, that comes in and out in lots of ways. So for me, I've been doing a lot of fulfilling my own perks. So I was drawing a lot of little monsters. If you bought a little monster, thank you very much for doing that. Right now I'm writing encouraging postcards, which was a perk from earlier this year. And then also development of the coming future, All right, that should give us a couple of times. And then also supporting Paola and Julia, who do a lot of the like coordinating and managing of the Project for Awesome, also with Nikki, trying to come up with ideas for perks, live stream host suggestions, what should the calendar be this year, like all of these conversations that are ongoing and exciting. And then before we know it, it's time for the next Project for Awesome, and I always feel bad when I get the email about the next Project for Awesome before I've finished doing my perks. So I was trying to beat that this year, and it just didn't quite work out. But I am on the final round of perks. Lex and I did a commentary for Emma, which was really fun. AFC Wimbledon just started their new season. I managed that sponsorship relationship, and also was able to go to two different AFC Wimbledon games at their new stadium, Plough Lane, which I really encourage you to go and visit. It's so beautiful. I brought my friend Dan along both times, and in both instances, AFC Wimbledon scored 3 goals. So I think he now has to come along to every single game, because it's only right. It's only the only way. The team is playing so beautifully and brilliantly, and I don't know how many years now we've sponsored AFC Wimbledon, but it's a number of years, and it's really exciting to manage that sponsorship. And I recall so clearly being in a Carluccio's at Waterloo, like just having a coffee with Ivor and Sam, who was at the time managed the commercial partnerships at AFC Wimbledon, and trying to explain who John was and what a Nerdfighter was and why this was actually a good thing. Now they're just fantastic partners. So there are all sorts of other things come up on the side of all of this. So I will do sort of like ad hoc bits of design. So like I designed the Nerdfighter community banners that you see in the stadium at AFC Wimbledon on the LED screens. I designed the ad for the Anthropocene Reviewed that's in the programmes. Just like bits and pieces that kind of come up, like headers on Twitter and video graphics and stuff like that. That are just like quick and easy, because I'm not a great designer, but just things that are quite simple I can do and enjoy doing as well. So that's something that just comes up quite randomly. And in fact, I was at an AFC Wimbledon game and I noticed someone looking through the programme, and I pointed out to Dan and I said, "Hey, I designed that." And he was like, "There's so many aspects to your job that I just don't know about," which is very true. So yes, I think that's like the basic summary of my work with John, although I'm sure I've missed massive things out. And then to the side of that, I'm writing my own things, just trying to write. I'm gonna say loads more about that right now because there's not really much to say, but I'm trying to write a lot, which I've definitely had loads more time for since I quit Instagram. Like loads more time for. It's been really fun. Trying to improve my website. I use Squarespace, but this isn't a Squarespace ad. Managing life, because I have technically, like, I have my own business. I'm a sole trader, but I have my own business, and there's a lot of like business management type stuff that comes up with it, and it just takes time. I think I still occasionally consult and like speak to people about the projects they're working on. There's so many birds, I love it. I do that less now because if I do it, I want to be able to give it time, and I just haven't really had the time or energy to put into that. And I'm also like protecting my own writing time a bit more than I used to, which is just divine. You know, not that I always do it, sometimes I just sit and play Hades for 2 hours, but I'm trying to write more. Yeah, reading takes up so much time because I'm reading ahead for my course a bit. I'm reading fiction just for fun. I'm reading for the books that I am going to write Life's Library letters for, and I update my reading on Storygraph, or try to. Or sometimes I just go in and bulk update everything, but that takes up a lot of time as well. I'm making more art. I'm doing pastel drawing. I'm playing with pastels at the moment, doing pastel drawing, and also these beautiful Japanese watercolors that I got from the shop Choosing Keeping. Yeah, the birds like that. Still doing a lot of strength training. I train with my trainer 2 days a week, and then I train by myself 1 day a week, and then I cycle everywhere. So that's sort of like my week in training. But that's been really fun because I've seen so much progress in my strength, and I was very worried coming out of lockdown that I would have lost it, but actually the muscles came back really quickly. I completed my cycle to John O'Groats. More of those videos soon. Oh yeah, I guess I also edit videos. Obviously. Yeah, I edit videos. I work on videos for a long time and then they go up eventually. There are things that are kind of like work, even though they're not technically work. And I think that like managing my mental health is very much that. So I still see my amazing therapist like every week, and have to do a lot of other like general health management stuff, like follow up with doctors and follow up with other experts, and just it is that's the one thing that sometimes I'm like, God, I wish I just had someone else who could coordinate all of this stuff for me, because having to constantly advocate for yourself gets really tiring sometimes. But I think I'm more on top of it now than I was, so that's had like a massive change in everything. But yeah, I think that's it. I think that's everything I do. but I've probably forgotten something. What do you do? Let me know in comments. This was lovely. What a lovely way to start the day. I'm going to go make breakfast now. Bye.
And I also, I saved a pigeon's life recently. Not that pigeon, but a pigeon. I feel like that's an important update.